We've got high hopes for this contest with these two fighters. Should be a Vasily the Matrix Lomachenko, Ukraine's finest. He's a former world champion in multiple weight classes.
This bout is scheduled for 20.
So much hype surrounding this big matchup. Can't wait to see what goes down when the opening bell rings.
I'm so giddy, so excited. The anticipation is...
High hopes for this battle between these two athletes. And he misses with that jab. Both men step back for just a moment. All the talking has been done. It's time to start doing the walking.
Did you see the nerve the fighter stepping into the ring, Tom? It can tell you so much about a fighter. And the look in the opposite corner, you've got one fighter that is in heaven. This is where they want to be.
And he just misses with that jab. Catch and shoot. Not many of the people in the division hit like them. What a world championship fight we're seeing, ladies and gentlemen. He misses with that jab. Who's willing to go where the other fighter won't? You don't want to trade shots. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. You know that bell was sweet music to his ears.
Don't be looking there for one.
And there's the bell for round two. A counterfighter relies a lot on their instincts and reaction time. You've got to get in there quick to punch your opponent before he gets his fist back to block.
If you're fighting a counterpuncher, you've got a dummy shot. Make them react from that, then react then. I know it's hard to think that way, but counterpunchers, they're watching your every move, that every trick.
So that left lands. Oh, and they just got their bell rung. Nice exchange here from both men. Some nice exchanges from both men in this round. It doesn't always pay to be first. It pays to be last. Nice exchange here from both men. Neither man really defending themselves. He missed with that jab. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. After what we saw in that last round, it's pretty obvious who has the advantage. Here we go in round three. Who's going to land the first big shot? We both know who the bigger power puncher is. There's a significant power difference. How would you handle that?
You've got to be courageous when you get in there with someone that's bigger, stronger, and faster. You've just got to use brain then.
That punch lands. It's all offense, all the time. There's a big difference between being the aggressor and the effective aggressor. Which type are we seeing so far?
Sometimes when you have a fight, the best way to beat a fight is not give them what they want. Because they want to get you there. They want you to stand there toe-to-toe with them and have a tell. That's what they do in the gym every single day of the week. What you've got to do is you've got to frustrate them as they set their shots. Get out of the way. And they'll get so angry, so frustrated because they can't work.
Some nice exchanges from both men in this ring. You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. That one will count. Very close round with 10 seconds to go. That bell could not have come soon enough for this guy.
Wow, it's like two different leagues.
Don't let him get back into his fight. It's so important now in the first minute. Look at him, he's absolutely knackered, man.
Here we go to the fourth round. How nervous would you get when you know you're facing a big puncher like this guy that can seriously hurt you?
Sometimes when you get in there with someone that's so powerful, you're thinking, you've just got to be smarter than them. You've got to be like a little fagin that's pickpocketing them.
There's no doubt that this fighter's power can change the fight around in an instant. You can't afford to make one single minor mistake. Another scoring shot. They won't give us a second to catch our breath. Some nice exchanges from both men in this round. In the early rounds of a fight, you'll see two boxers feel each other out, test each other's power, and I think this boxer has decided I can walk through anything that lands.
What a gift. What a gift it is to have a chin where you know you can walk through anything and everything. When you let those shots go and it's just bouncing off and they're walking you down, it's so demoralizing. It absolutely breaks your heart. What else can you do?
Threw the hook, didn't land. Very close round with 10 seconds to go. That was almost a 10-8 round. Complete dominance. On to the fifth we go. Both of these men showing exceptional chins, by the way. Swing and a miss with that hook. This fighter is sort of the death by a thousand paper cuts approach. He'll hit you a thousand times before you can land one.
What you've got to do, Tony, is anticipation. You've got to wait. You've just got to throw caution to the wind and just hope. You're never going to know where the shots are coming from. You've just got to put in a guess.
punch. Nice exchanges from both men in this round. Fantastic punch. They call it the chin. How strong is your chin? Do you have a glass chin? These are things that can affect the fight.
I've seen some fighters with a granite chin. You can hit them with a sledgehammer, they are not going to move. But then I've seen some mad punchers with a chin like a crisp. As soon as you touch them, they're gone. And this is the danger spot.
There's a scoring blow. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. It finally happened! It was just a matter of time, and down he goes! Not many people would have predicted it, but we've got a knockout victory.
A knockout victory? That's not a knockout victory. That is somebody saying, I'm here, I've arrived. Try that again, it will happen all over again.